60 Minutes advises the following segment contains adult themes. Parental guidance is recommended.
We thought it was a haven, a model school where disadvantaged young boys and Catholic brothers all lived together as one big happy family. You may remember it from the famous lottery that raised millions in its name. But Boys Town in Bow Desert, Queensland, wasn't the godly place we all believed it to be. For many of the boys there, it was a pure hell. Those kids are grown men now. Tonight, after a lifetime of shame, they've found the courage to talk about what happened to them at Boys Town. Their stories are some of the hardest I've ever heard. But for the first time, the authorities are listening, and court action has now begun in what's becoming one of the largest cases of its type in Australian legal history.
Do you remember the horse yards, Mal?
Yeah.
And then Cottage 7.
This is the hardest journey to make for these men. They're returning to a place that's haunted them their entire adult lives.
Had his little room just out the back here where that room is.
A place filled with painful memories that very quickly flood back.
But why us? Why did we have to go through what we did?
This is Boys Town, or what's left of it. Just an hour out of Brisbane, it was both home and school for the boys who had nowhere else to go. They were the vulnerable ones who'd been abandoned, orphaned, or just got into a bit too much trouble. Here, though, they were promised a caring family environment and a future. But this place hid terrible secrets. And now, for the first time, you'll hear what really went on behind closed doors at Boys Town.
I don't know how to do this.
It's the hardest of stories to tell.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guys.
It's OK.
Just some of the stories that I've already heard is just sick. It doesn't make you sick in the stomach.
It's not easy. It's only the tip of the iceberg.
I still have nightmares, I've got flashbacks, you know.
Tonight, we'll uncover an abuse scandal that darkens a respected Catholic institution.
How many of you were sexually abused at Boys Town?
I'm still embarrassed.
This is going to be one of the largest child abuse cases in Australia's history.
We'll reveal that landmark Supreme Court action has begun against the church.
Brother Paul, Michael Usher from 60 Minutes.
And we'll seek answers from the De La Salle brothers who ran Boys Town.
Why were there so many boys under your care whilst you were in charge of Boys Town who were abused, assaulted, in some cases raped?
I'm not aware of that.
Almost everyone's heard of the famous Boys Town lotteries, which help fund a range of welfare and charity services around Australia. It also helped fund this, a bush farm in Bow Desert, Queensland. It closed in 2001, but for four decades, this Boys Town facility had a reputation for turning troubled young lives around.
There's only about three of you who haven't taken off at some stage.
We featured Boys Town on 60 Minutes in 1984. And spoke with then-director, Brother Paul Smith.
I think it's terribly important to be loved. And I think the boys who leave Boys Town can honestly say that at least they know they are lovable. And that's important.
But at this very same time, it's now alleged some of the worst abuse was being committed by some of the Catholic De La Salle brothers.
Did you talk amongst each other? Did the boys talk about what was going on?
Not really, no. You were ashamed.
Mal Burrows was 12 years old when he was placed at Boys Town in 1981 after his mother was murdered by his father.
This is your file from Boys Town.
Yeah.
The 15th of March 1983. It's a Boys Town hospital referral. You were sent to hospital on this occasion?
Yeah.
And it mentions stomach pains. What happened there?
I was raped. But it just came out of stomach pains, you know.
The only thing they gave you was Mylanta.
You know, I've been raped.
And you couldn't tell them that?
No.
Not the nurses, not the doctors? Why not?
Because so many other boys had been sent there too, and nothing had ever been done. Who was going to listen to us? How can you talk about it? Who's going to listen to you?
How many times do you think that you were raped?
Don't know. To be honest, I don't know.
Too many to count?
Too many to remember.
Yeah.
I haven't cried in a long time.
I haven't heard worse than what I've heard that happened to these small boys at Boys Town in Bow Desert.
Solicitor and former detective Jason Parkinson is a veteran litigator in clergy abuse cases. He is now representing 35 former Boys Town students and has begun legal action in Queensland Supreme Court.
I haven't heard the degree of physical abuse together with some of the most outrageous sexual abuse I've heard in the one institution before.
We're talking about the worst sort of abuse, there's no doubt about that.
Things happen to some of these 12-year-old boys that wouldn't have happened to prisoners of war.
I copped a strap in the mouth, just as a, you know, a backhander from him. Split me lip, had stitches.
The brothers beat us senseless. I've still got a broken nose.
You okay?
After years of silence, these men are now going public.
And the silence ends now with this, you know, and we need everybody to know what happened.
All want justice. Some want the brothers brought before the courts, and dozens have joined the civil claim that names 9 De La Salle brothers, including Cormac and Finbar, plus 7 others that we can't name for legal reasons.
How many of you were sexually abused at Boys Town? Mike, how tough is that to admit?
National TV. Very, very hard. Because I'm a father. It's just very, very hard. Very, very hard. I don't know how to put it in words. I hope we're not judged by our peers, our work colleagues, and ridiculed, because we've been living with it.
Well, I tried to commit suicide by covering my whole body in petrol and lighting myself alight. And the only help I got was a shit kicked out of me and thrown into the cell for a couple of days.
They bringing out things like cattle prods, and I got zapped 3 or 4 times and thrown into the jail cell, and I was in there for 2 days straight, no water, naked.
We're going to expose the truth, and we're going to do that together in unity.
Terry McDaniel was rejected by his mother when he was a young boy, placed in foster care, then sent to Boys Town, age 12.
It's nice, isn't it?
Today, he has a loving wife and a stable family of his own. But it's only in the past few months that he's revealed to them what happened at Boys Town.
How old are you there?
I think I was 14 then.
If you could talk to that 14-year-old boy now, what would you say?
Hang in there, mate. Hang in there.
By then, had you been abused?
Yes.
You had a responsibility to take care of us, okay? I was under a care and protection order, okay? That's what I was under. You failed that.
Brother Paul Smith was the public face of Boys Town.
He was the director of the home at Bow Desert from 1982 to 1993, when Terry was a student there.
We try and introduce the boys to a stability, a type of sharing.
28 years ago, when we caught up with him, Brother Paul was like a father to these boys.
Can you look into my eyes?
Now men, they want explanations for what the outside world couldn't see.
What about all the strip searches?
Totally untrue. No memory of that.
No memory of that, yeah. That's convenient, isn't it?
How many of you were strip searched when you were at Boys Town?
All of us would have been.
Repeatedly.
It's untrue.
That are they making it up? That's,
no, that is true.
Yes. Well, I have a false memory.
A false memory?
That has been dealt with.
No, false memory. False memory, no.
Terry says there is nothing false or fabricated about his memory of the brother who molested him.
He took me to one of the rooms where the brother's quarters was, where the brother slept. He made me stand in front of him and he asked me to drop my dacks. I didn't argue with him. I dropped my dacks and, he had a pretty good feel.
Did he say anything?
He just said that as he was feeling around, is it okay? He just kept asking me, is it okay? What was I feeling?
Megan, how do you feel when you hear your husband telling that story?
Sad. Very sad.
If I can ask you, is that the worst of it? Or is there more?
There's more.
That happened to you?
There's a lot more, yeah.
What about the time that I ran away with...
Brother Paul Smith today is a highly commended charity and welfare figure in the De La Salle Order and won't hear of these allegations.
So let me be really clear about this, because there'll be investigations. You're saying that Terry is lying, he's making it up?
I'm saying that he has a false memory.
So he's making it up?
No, he's a false memory. I'm thinking his life may have been astray, he may be looking for excuses. Not him, but people in similar circumstances, they do this. Anything that came up by way of physical or sexual abuse was reported. Any sexual abuse that came up was reported to the police.
That's true, and at least two brothers from Boys Town were convicted of child sex offences. But it's the dozens of new allegations which went unreported that are the subject of these new claims.
What, you're saying that you can't remember now?
Can you put him back on a leash or something?
I've been right.
The current head of the Australian De La Salle Order is Brother Ambrose Payne. We played him just some of these men's stories.
Can you talk about it? Who's going to listen to you?
It's not easy to watch.
Not at all.
When you hear his story, how do you feel about what he's recounting?
Probably the most expressive word is gutted. The matter is a very serious matter, and that there's no way in the world that we will dodge it.
Why were boys strip searched at Boys Town?
I have no knowledge of whether boys were strip searched at Boys Town.
Every single one of them says they were strip searched and strip searched regularly.
That's appalling.
This wasn't a prison.
That's true.
It was a care facility for young boys.
It was a care facility, yes, and, you know, what else can I say except agree with you?
Does that action, that behaviour at Boys Town, surprise you in any way?
It surprises me and appalls me, and I'm absolutely devastated, really.
But none of this should be a surprise, because we've now learned that Boys Town was the subject of a 3-year secret police investigation known as Operation Sari, which commenced in 1999. It resulted in two staff being charged with 48 serious sexual offences. But the case collapsed when former students withdrew complaints. Exactly why remains a mystery. Why has it taken so long for them to tell their story?
Child abuse is almost the perfect crime. They reach an age in their 40s, late 40s, early 50s, when from that time they can look back on their life and say, well, there's nothing else that's occurred, and I'm now going to tell my story.
And they are beginning what will be a testing legal challenge. The word of broken men against the might of the Catholic Church.
It should never have happened. Because I never wanted any child to ever go through what I went through. Never.
No matter how painful and confronting, they have already taken the hardest step, and that's breaking their silence.
I would like to see them, if there was enough evidence, with enough boys to come forward, to have charges laid and actually stand in front of a magistrate and let a magistrate decide their fate.
Mm. What would that help you with, do you think?
For the first time, I was able to tell my story. Mm. And someone believed me.
And we can now report that as a result of this story and the number of men coming forward, Queensland Police have now launched Operation Kilo Lariat, a fresh investigation into the Boys Town home at Beaudesert.